Welcome to Load Blower Studios. This is where loads get blown.
Load Blower Studios. Let's see. It started off as a joke, then became a hobby, then became an obsession, and now it's a passion. Basically, my band, Fate Worse Than Death, whenever we recorded an album, I was really interested in the recording process, and eventually I started this joke solo project called Load Blower, which was just me writing stupid heavy deathcore songs, and I wanted to get them recorded. I figured, hey, why not record them myself? So I did that, and I kind of fell in love with the process, and you know, the snowball started rolling, and I got more involved in recording and audio engineering and mixing and mastering, and kind of fell in love with it all. So I figured, hey, you know, why not record other bands? You know, it started off with my bands. I recorded another band I play guitar in called Flawed Heroes. I recorded an EP with them, and I recorded Fate Worse Than Death's last full length. And I was like, all right, well, why not record other bands? You know, why not record local bands that are like me? You know, that want to have good quality recordings and not have to go to some like big huge studio and pay like $5,000 for an EP or a full length or whatever. So, and that's kind of where Load Blower was born.
Pussy Jamz 2015.
Pussy Jamz.
That's the best album title I've ever heard.
Well, my cousin and I, we were always close growing up. We were only like months apart. So, and we always had the same interests. You know, we were into bands like Korn and Limp Bizkit and stuff like that. And we used to hang out at each other's houses all the time, have sleepovers. So in 2005, just one random afternoon, we didn't even really have any idea in our head of what was going to come out of that afternoon. But we just decided to start writing just stupid songs. Somehow we ended up slapping the label Grind of the Dead on it. We wrote our whole first album in like 3 hours. You know, it was just using wicked shitty drums, like MIDI drums. We were using the old desktop microphone to record an amp that was across the room. So it doesn't sound good at all. There was no thought put into it. It was just spur of the moment. Just let's see what we can do. And even back then, you know, we called it Grind of the Dead. We wanted it to be a joke grindcore project, but we didn't even really know what grindcore was. Like, my idea of grindcore was, you know, a band like Daughters or something like that. I didn't listen to bands like Napalm Death or anything like that at that time. But we put out that album, which, you know, we were the only ones that really listened to it anyways. And about a month later, we were like, oh, let's do another one. And, you know, my cousin had put in a new sound card, so we could actually this time plug the guitar straight into the computer. And the second album, which we called Necrofag, it does sound better than the first one. There was actually more thought put into it. You know, I wrote pretty much all the songs on guitar. My cousin did the programming on the drums. He helped me with some of the vocals. But I did actually put some thought into those riffs. I did take some time to actually plan things out a little more. And then, you know, after that, here and there, we should do a third album. But, you know, we kind of drifted apart a little bit after that. You know, we were in college at the time. We had girlfriends. We started working jobs. And, you know, just shit happens. And, you know, here and there, I'd say, oh, we should do another grind album. And it was years and years and years that it always floating around in my head. I always wanted to do it. Until finally, last year, my stepdad's company was doing a family outing at Canopy Lake Park, and my cousin was there, and he had recently broken up with his girlfriend of like 4 or 5 years. So finally, you know, he had the free time. I had the free time, and we just started talking, and I was like, dude, we should do this for real. So he was down for it. And I just started getting to work writing songs. I wrote 46 demos in about a month. And we did get together one weekend and started trying to plot out the album. We started trying to map out drums. But I could tell a little early on that maybe it wasn't the right time for my cousin Nana. We were having a bit of a hard time with the drums. And I could just tell that my enthusiasm for the project wasn't quite matching up to his. You know, he's busy with his job, and he's trying to save up for a new apartment, things like that. So his kind of priorities were a little different from mine. And so I ended up getting in contact with Ray, who I'd known from Fate Worse Than Death. But he had asked me to do guest vocals for a Fate Worse Than Death song on their new upcoming album. So we ended up chatting there at his house, and I just kind of ran it by him because I saw that he had his home studio, and I said, you know, would you be down to record this album? I've been writing it. I told him, you know, I got to warn you, it's 40 songs. And he was kind of like, oh shit, but let's fucking do it. I kind of told my cousin that I was still going ahead with the record, and you know, he was fine with that. You know, he obviously wasn't going to be able to be present for it. So from there, it kind of became more of a solo project to me. And so I initially had 46 demos, and I trimmed that down to 40 songs. I cut out the stuff that I didn't really like or wasn't really working. And me and Ray started laying it down.
I'm gonna put my dick in.
Guitar feedback, and the other one's kind of the opening riff is just like. Lay it down, baby, lay it down. Some sweet soul.
Tuning.
Loud guitars. Look at this kid up here with his fucking two screens.
Well, why is this over here?
Bunch of other cool projects. He's finally in studio with us.
What's going on?
Promoting, what's the latest outfit?
It's Grind of the Dead. So like a solo project kind of. I started it 10 years ago with my cousin, and it was awful. We just writing terrible songs on the computer, MIDI drums, you know, just really awful. But I always wanted to write a real album for the project, so I don't know, as of recently I finally had the time, I had the means. Ray here really hooked it up. He has a nice home studio, which he's now turned into Load Blower Studios, which, you know, if you're a new band or you're looking to record an EP or something, you should definitely hit him up, because it sounds awesome.
Right on. And how do you find the time? Because you've got a full-time job, you just had a kid not long ago, so just like... Where do you find the time? I don't feel productive enough. Like, aside from my job and this, I'm like, I have no time for anything.
You pull it out of nowhere. I mean, nap time is everything. Everything. Every little 10 minute of silence, 15 minutes here and there, you just got to work with it. I mean, I wrote the songs, excuse me, while my girlfriend was still pregnant, so the baby wasn't around yet. But now that the baby's here, it's just really kind of prioritizing your time. A little baby girl, you know, I started that band when I was 13. Just friends on the street. I mean, it was really nice because our guitarist, Jimmy, lived three houses down this way.
Yeah.
Our bassist, Matt, lived three houses down that way. Like, we kind of lived on, like, a horseshoe-shaped kind of road.
Yeah.
So it's nice. We were always right there. And Eric lived, like, two streets down. So we were always, like, that's one thing that was nice about it back then. It was, like, we were all friends first. We all live close together, so, which is something I think is really important. You know, it's really hard to be in a band with people that are just there to, like, play music. You know, it's like the friendship is really what kind of holds it together.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, we just always put our all into it. I mean, we started out as, like, nu metal, because that's, you know, that's all we knew at the time. We're, like, 13. Eric, when he joined the band, he was, like, 10 or 11 years old, but he was just a phenomenal drummer. And actually, for like the first, it's kind of funny because like for the first 2 years of the band, nobody liked us. Everyone was like crapping on us at school. Everyone was telling us like how awful we were and this and that. But we just always just kept chugging along, you know, just getting better and better. And yeah, we did finally end up signing a label deal, which was exciting at first until it turned out to be pretty much a joke. But
all right, and we're gonna save a lot of the kind of like those little interesting stories for the second hour, because sure. I feel like you've got a lot of. We can pick your brain for some yeah. Good advice for young and upcoming bands.
I'm writing a book about it right now, so y'all got plenty of advice, plenty of stories.
You know, initially Pussy Jamz was I was just trying to make the most offensive album I could. That was always kind of the point of Grind of the Dead. Early on, we just tried to make kind of like silly and stupid songs. You know, anything that's offensive or whatever. But the album kind of started to change as it progressed through the process there. I mean, initially, I was just going for, like, straight-up offensive. I was just trying to think of the most kind of ridiculously offensive things I could think of. And that's kind of easy these days, you know, when everyone kind of getting upset over every little comment that's made. But as we kind of started working on the album, I kind of started paying attention to different things, and I realized that I could still make an offensive point or offend people, but also make a valid point or, you know, touch upon something in society that didn't sit well with me. You know, there's plenty of things on the news. There's so much going on in the world today. And so, while there are still some songs on the album that are just kind of outright ridiculous for the sake of being ridiculous, I did start to put more of a serious effort into what I was trying to say with some of these songs. I mean, there's a song about the whole incident in Ferguson, which is, you know, I realize is a little old news now, but when we started the album, that was a current topic that was going on. You know, there's songs about loneliness, there's songs about the meaning of life. So that while it's masked in, I guess you would say satire, there is a lot of kind of deep discussion on this album, still mixed in with some not so serious stuff to make for kind of a nice mix.
Hey, hey, check, 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 hey, check, 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 one, two, check, check. What the fuck is going on with this thing?
Why? This is not picking up.
Like it is, it's just super quiet. Hey, 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 check, hey, yeah, yeah. Quiet on the dead, motherfucker!
And another thing that I wanted to do right from the start is I wanted to just make this a really collaborative effort. I wanted to have as many guest vocalists as possible. I've been doing music for a long time. I've met a lot of people. I know a lot of bands. And I just thought it would be cool, you know, coming back after a 10-year hiatus. Not that anyone really knew who Grind of the Dead was before, but I really wanted to make this album special. So right from the get-go, I wanted to have just as many guest vocals as possible. And, you know, it's really awesome how it came out. You know, most people that I approached about it were down for it. We got quite a few awesome vocalists on there. A lot of surprises, too. You know, we got some female singers on the album. We got some, you know, some veterans that have been doing it for a long time. I got people on the album that aren't even really vocalists, but, you know, they wanted to do it, so when you listen to it, there's a lot of different sounds, and you know, I really just want to thank all the guest vocalists for lending their talents, and all of you helped make this record what it is.
Wait till you see my dick. Wait till you see my dick. Hey, bitch, wait till you see my dick. I'ma beat that pussy up like
we gotta keep that for like a bonus track or something. I recorded that. We gotta keep that as like a bonus track or some shit.
Dude, play that.
Wait till you see my dick. Wait till you see my dick. Hey, bitch. Wait till you see my dick. I'ma beat that pussy up. Like, back off, Brian Ferguson! Fuck the color of your skin! Back off,
oh, fuck your mother!
Back off, Brian Ferguson! Back off, Brian Ferguson!
Oh, that last one. I don't know about the second one. Let's check it out.
Let's hear him.
Fucking lick the fucking goo and crust in between your fucking toenails. Oh, I want you to try to smell
yeah, baby,
your
yeah.
Fucking balls.
I can adjust whatever.
Pretty loud-ish.
Alright, so...
like on a scale of 1 to 10, probably like a 7 or an 8.
Everyone out in the world can't die! It's all in time! Remain alive!
Yeah, the way I like to explain is you got to gig it and you got to rig it. You know, you gig your rig and you got to rig your gig. And that's just how she goes.
That's a philosophy of lesser life.
Absolutely. Gigging and rigging till the day I die, really.
I prefer loading and blowing.
I mean, you heard it from the man yourself, eh?
I prefer grinding and deading.
I like it, you know? It suits you.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, mate.
Sometimes you just have lots of loads, and they build up, and you just gotta blow.
Sometimes you got a lot of...
If goods. You don't blow the load, it's a fate worse than death.
Dude, I'm actually 20.
Fuck, bro.
Yeah, right?
You can't even drink, dude?
I mean, I don't claim it. I actually hate straight edge people.
But you don't do anything.
Correct.
So you're like me.
Kind of, yeah.
Dude, you're not going to do all that weed on tour and shit?
Dude, I'm going to, like, eat spoonfuls of it.
You're gonna inject all the weeds?
Yo, real life, I have sold, like, pot brownies to, like, an old black guy.
Dude, I love shooting up marijuana.
Dude, it's so dope.
Hi, bro. Wait, no, scream for me.
Yeah!
I love it. All right, you ready?
Hulkamania is calling my name.
Yeah, brother.
Yeah.
Is the volume good enough for you?
A little more.
Just gonna click 8 times, then you're gonna scream.
Yeah, as if I... Okay, whatever, Dad.
All right, son.
Thanks.
Die after die after die after die!
You're sure?
Mm-mm. I didn't like that.
Three die hipsters.
Yeah,
well. And then die.
You know what? I just want to die.
Yeah! Yeah! The dog special! Life at your horn!
Look at this Mainer. They don't got thrash metal up in Maine.
No, they just have so, these really weird...
Except like, for Holy Bills.
Dumb as worthless as the shit you call art!
Yeah.
Vocals.
You got it,
by
kid?
Your boy.
Your boy.
Your boy. Your boy.
Holla at your boy. You're right, kid. Let's do it.
Alright.
Check the mic for me.
Microphone, check my phone. Is it too quiet? Or?
You could turn up a bit too, but also the other track started playing, so it's fucking me up a bit too.
Oh, I knew that.
Like, I started singing and I hear like, raff, raff, raff,
raff. That's it. All right.
Hold on, can you play it out loud, please? Mountain Dew, baby.
Nothing felt me like it should!
Want to hear it first?
Okay. Did that sound like it spinning?
This bitch.
Sky, I would go pay with that cocker. for you! I found Vicky Scott! Kaka! Dive! Dive! Come!
Did you say kaka?
Yeah, it's shit, poop, feces, scat. I want to paint with that. Cucka, dung, dump, crap. I want to paint with that.
Yeah, I'm an artist, bitch!
There we go,
fucking song is done. Fucking cool. Hey girl, wanna go be on the dumpster and get fucking real?
Okay. Ooh girl, you make me wanna pull down my pants. Oh, oh.
Keep talking.
Yeah! Oh, girl. Oh, baby girl. You make me wanna pull down my pants. Oh! Hey, 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 hey.
Hey, brother.
Come on now. Hey!
Hey, snap it to a Slim Jim.
What?
Take 21.
Let's get a fucking real!
Are you ready?
Yeah. Gang vocals. Take one.
Parts about recording with Ray is that, you know, there was no real time frame for anything. You know, normally you go to the studios, you'd already have your songs ready to go, they're charging you by the hour, so you're just trying to get in there, get it done as quickly as possible, and pay the less, you know, the least amount of money that you can. But with Ray, you know, it was just two friends. You know, I just kind of paid as I, you know, as I could as we went along, but you know, that we didn't have a time frame. It wasn't like I had to get it done in X amount of time. I would, you know, I had a baby, so, you know, I'm working a lot. So I was only going about, you know, one night a week. And we'd go for about, you know, about a 6-hour block or so. But it was just nice because there was no pressure for anything. And it allowed me time to really sit back and think about a lot of things. And the songs have changed dramatically from the demo stages. There's so many songs that don't even sound anything like what they started out as. And, you know, we got to experiment with a lot of things. We got to try out a bunch of effects, and it was just nice because as I was kind of learning how to make these songs better and really creating the album that I wanted to make, it was also allowing Ray to learn a lot about his studio and about how to do different things. And, you know, I'd come back the next week and he'd be like, oh, you know, check this out, look what I learned how to do. And so we were both kind of helping each other out, which is really cool.
Oh, yeah, tracheotomy. Yeah. It was old. And that shit, like,
it's a band name, Butthole Tracheotomy.
What's up, guys, with Butthole Tracheotomy?
Oh, yeah, look at the weird dicks. No, I think those dicks were there.
Those are supposed to be suspenders.
Did you put those dicks there?
I put them in a weird...
Did you put those dicks there?
I put them in a weird little tank top.
Oh, it's like a spaghetti strip.
Yeah, see? Because they wear those.
Dick top!
And he's growing his beard in.
Spaghetti dick.
His beard's coming out.
It's like carrot top, but dick top.
It's dicks.
I see what you're doing.
Sharks with dick tops. And vagina noses.
Oh, man, I would fuck that nose.
Are his eyes tits?
You could ride that shit.
Are his eyes, those are tits. His eyes are tits.
I wouldn't ride it because
spraying milk, spraying blood out of the vagina, and spraying cum out of the dick. I just don't have a butt spraying shit.
What are you doing for that? What's an art? What's a piece of art without a butt spraying shit?
I've got the key, I'm begging, please let me open your back door. I won't, but I won't get sick if I get a shit on my dick. If I get a little shit on my dick. Hey, y'all! Sticks!
Those are both solid as fuck.
Just a joke, but...
Okay, you ready?
It might not be, though.
Vocals are no joke.
Here we go.
Yep.
I'm a pizza hole pizza, give it to me right now! Pepperoni and bologna, then you suck it down! Come on, baby, don't bologna, I'll get some lemon, then raise a piece of fucking red, push your pussy to the death!
Cloud, bitch! Take that cloud like a good bitch! Cloud.
You all just vape them and you close the friggin' door on
them. There's the...
No! Vape closet!
What's up? Vape by you guys.
King vape!
This guy's just vaping me. I wasn't recording, you dumb idiot.
Oh, I just wasted my voice. How am I going to shred later?
Alright, this guy's right here.
If you laugh, I don't sing. Unless I'm singing my, to my
You got to get in on this, Sam. Oh, I'm not in the picture, am I?
Tank, come on.
I'm going to be in the picture.
Come on, you can scream.
Might have to back up a little bit.
Hold on. Yeah, I don't need to be on.
There you are. I see you.
There you my man tits.
We're all going to do a test. I'm going to count to three. We're going to go pizza pussy party, alright? Yeah. I want to see how the level looks. One, two, three.
Pizza pussy party!
Sweet. Get up a little bit.
All right, you guys ready?
Yep. I'm ready.
Oh, shit.
Pizza pussy party!
Let's
fuck that. I fucking do
I fecked it up.
That's good.
I fecked it up.
All right. After he screams at work.
Dude, somebody just vaped all over that track, man.
Pizza pussy party! Pizza pussy party! I fucked a car and fucked her all night long!
I fucked it.
Grimy.
Pretty, yeah, it was
pretty
much space.
Money.
Yeah, man.
The style that we're going for is, I don't want to cut it up. You know what I mean?
Yeah, no, it has to be, like, one fucking take.
How the fuck am I going to... I can't even read your chicken scratch.
You gotta have a moment.
You're an actor.
Just scrap his vocals, his lyrics, and then just make it up.
It's gonna be hard.
You
You can do it.
Let's just fucking try it. I'm probably gonna ruin it, but...
We'll
give it a go.
Ruin
yeah.
it really good, though.
Yeah.
You ready, bro? I'm gonna catch this on.
All right, great question.
I remember the first time that party with Kate felt like a dream. And we fucked for days.
Goddamn too motherfucking
slow.
Pussy
a little
jams.
Too slow. But...
motherfucking pussy. Can I just say motherfucking pussy jam?
I remember the first time at the party with Kate. It felt like a dream, and we fucked for days. She called it pussy jams.
Pussy, pussy, pussy. Pussy jams.
Pussy jams.
Oh, no.
And I was never the same. I wanted more, needed more, and more came. At the cost of all my mother's money, my friends, the world I had known, slowly disappearing with each hit. They say hell is fire and brimstone. They have no fucking idea. Hell is losing teeth and sleep. Hell is fuck.
So back it up.
So back it up with a stream of piss.
Yeah, I kind of read it.
Ready?
Yep. So back it up with a stream of piss! Ow! My face!
What did it sound like?
If God is dead!
That's okay. Yeah.
So it won't be that high, it'll just kind of like a, it'll be like a minor note in between.
Why do we even try?
Yeah! That one.
Okay.
That's the
one. Do it like that every time.
That's the money.
Are we just doing that part, the whole thing?
The whole thing.
Are you ready?
Ready.
Here we go, we sing, Young American Girl.
Not American. Anything. We're simply robots wondering why. What is the point then? Why do we even try?
Oh, fuck.
All right, buddy, work your fucking magic.
I think that's it.
The Mammoth God's fucking dead! Cause I'm about to become famous! The killer is in you! Roll this away!
Motherfucking Kanye West, he thinks he is the fucking best, but I grasp my... Oh, fuck. Single, fun-loving, blonde, 5'5", North Face jacket, black, and designer jeans tucked into Ugg boots. Says things like, what? And, oh my god! She runs on Dunkin', loves Starbucks, and can't even whenever country music comes on the radio.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm extremely proud of the record. You know, I put a lot into it. I've never worked this long or this hard on a project before. And, you know, it feels especially good because, you know, I pretty much did it all by myself, which I've always wanted to do a solo album, so this kind of works well as that. But just how it all came together and all the things that came out of it, I got to meet a lot of cool people that I haven't seen in a long time. You know, I made a great friend with Ray. We weren't that close from the start of this, but you know, it's been really great, just all these cool positive things that have come from this, and I really can't wait to put it out. I think it's one of the best things I've been a part of.
All right, so Grind of the Dead, Pussy Jamz, what can I tell you about that? It's been a great experience. I've learned a lot through recording this album. So basically, me and Alex were acquaintances that decided to start doing this out of kind of mutual project. I was like, hey, you know, I'm getting into recording. I want to, you know, try some more stuff. And he was like, oh, hey, I have this project that I want to mess around with and get recorded. If you want to record me, you know, we could both learn stuff during this, and I could, you know, write this album and get this finally done, and you can record something, and that'll be really cool. So I was like, all right, let's do that. So it was a big undertaking. It's 40 songs, so it ended up taking about a year, over a year, to do. And and over the course of that, Load Blower turned from just me, you know, recording stuff myself for the hell of it to a full-fledged business. So, of course, I learned a hell of a lot during it. I would say the most fun part of, I'd say, would be learning the mechanics of how to do different effects for recording, learning a bit more about different editing techniques, and, you know, thinking like, oh, you know, this part would sound really cool if we had this kind of, like, effect or this kind of sound, or if it kind of did this kind of thing. And then, you know, doing research and figuring out how to make that exact sound and how to make that effect happen, how to edit it in this way to make it come out just the way I want. So that's probably been the most fun. That and doing collaboration. So the album has, you know, a million guest vocals and guest guitar spots and things like that. And that was really enjoyable, just having a bunch of folks in the studio and getting different voices on tracks and, you know, kind of learning the dynamics of how different people sing and different people scream and things like that. And I got to learn a lot about how to record, you know, like classical singing, things like that. That was really fun. So I would say the fact that recording this album expanded my horizons a lot in the things I like to record, the things I enjoy listening to, and it kind of gives me a newfound respect for different types of music and, you know, what goes into recording them and the people that are able to play that music. I also would say probably the biggest part that was the most enjoyable about the whole process was making friends with Alex. So me and him, you know, we were just kind of acquaintances at first, and through the year of doing this, we became really close friends. We learned a lot about each other, shared a lot of stories. You know, we're very similar dudes, and I know it's kind of cool. Load Blower kind of grew as his friendship with me and Alex grew, and now we're best of friends. So that was that's been really good. That's probably been the biggest takeaway from this whole process was making a friend like that. So, yeah, hats off, Pussy Jamz. Let's do it. Going.
Oh, I need you to play the first part.
Oh. Like the first part of the song?
Yeah, just so I get like the feel.
Oh, okay. You ready?
Yeah.
No, the, what we just did.
Oh! Oh! All right, you ready?
It's yeah. Great.
Scream to your heart's content. Yeah! I'm just going to lose my heart! I'm just going to be right! I'm just going to be right! I'm just going to be right! I'm just going to be right!